Sherpa, and I'm so excited today. I have this fully guided art lesson. May the fourth be with you. I'm going to show you how to do everything in this painting in just a couple hours. All you've got to do is grab your brushes, grab your paints, come right back here and meet me at this easel right now. May the force be with you. Welcome to the studio. I'm so glad you came. If you are a returning artist, hey guys, it is so good to see you. If you're brand new, this is how this works. I paint this whole thing. I tell you everything I'm doing. I don't give you like 20 minutes, like really short, when you needed like the whole thing and then say go to this other place and do it. It's the whole lesson. So you can absolutely get this done with me here today. It is a fully guided art project. You're gonna love it. I'd like to dedicate this particular episode to my friends Matt and Dom, who've been super supportive of the Sherpa and also are incredible supporters of Star Wars. They've been to Skywalker Ranch. They have the most amazing fine art Star Wars collection on the planet. I'd like to do a shout out to my cousin Cecil, who he and his whole family like to like get their like Jedi on and go to like conventions and stuff, and to all my awesome geek artists who are so signed up for this today and ready to go. Materials: you're gonna need 16 by 20 canvas of some kind, pre-gessoed. The only time you need to re-gesso over these is if the coating, like the gesso that they provided for you, was just yuck and you're not enjoying your experience with your canvas. You can apply a coat there, but other than that, you should be able to just open them right out of the package, get that new gesso smell, and get started. Now, I have some exciting news today. I'm painting with the Maestro series from the TheArtSherpa. They wrote me, you know how I'm always like, nobody ever talks to me? They talked to me, and they were like, would you try our brushes? And if you like our brushes, would you talk about our brushes? So I was like, I will try them, but I guarantee you nothing. Nothing. So I took them to a 720 pop-up show, which is the Visual Art Alliance's little show here in Houston. They do it at least once a year, hopefully more. And I painted a piece. I sat out there in the sun, painted a piece, and I'm going to have a review for you. And I'm going to do this whole piece with them. I want you to look inside this pretty case. Look inside this pretty case. So you can get these on Amazon. And it is pretty much every brush that I'm ever using up here. So that's the first point that I like to say I liked about them. I was abusive to these brushes, like on another level. I didn't even clean them up before bringing them here. I mean, I just used them and was like, this is what it is. They've got synthetic and they've got natural fibers. And listen, right now off the bat, I can tell you this right now. If you are a multimedia artist, if you're doing more than just acrylic with me, if you are scrapbooking, if you're doing multimedia pieces, if you're like sometimes in watercolor and then you're over in inks and then you're in oils and then you're in acrylics, this, and you don't have like the ability to get a complete set of specialty brushes for each medium, this is a really great way to go because they will work for all those. And also, if you have a metal allergy, I guess this is nickel. I don't have metal allergies, but I have allergies, like, and I can imagine that not having that triggered would be great. And it's got all this nice storage. I enjoyed it. We're going to talk about it as I paint with them. And, oh, and they're totally going to give you guys like a massive, massive discount. So there's a way to get a lifetime guarantee on them. And if you check out the description and everything down here, you can go get like an amazing discount. So they'll be super, super considerate of your budget, which I did like. I did like. Paint! Need some of that, right? Paint, you need some paint. Cad yellow, yellow ochre, dioxazine purple, phthalo blue, cadmium red, titanium white. What am I painting? I'm painting what I always paint, which is pro acrylics. And I'm always telling you, just paint with the best paint that your budget will allow from a company that cares what your consumer experience is. You know I'm Liquitex, you know I've got Golden, you know I've got Matisse, but just whatever company treats you decently. Now, this is my favorite edition. I think it's the most important thing for today. This is Cowgirl Nomosa, because when you have no champagne, you gotta be ready with your no-mosa. So all you need for this is some fresh squeezed orange juice and then whatever cider, I'm not kidding, this is the yummiest thing, whatever cider, hard cider that your husband has left in the fridge. So if your girlfriends are coming over and you're like, oh my God, I gotta come up with something really fast, you can no-mosa. And it is super yummy. I'm a huge fan of this. In fact, champagne schmampagne, cowgirl no-mosa for days. I'm gonna put this on the website. More exciting than all of that. Okay, you're gonna love this. You're gonna die for this. Do you see this? Do you see this? This is right now, I made sure this was ahead of time on our website. This is a vector image. You can scale it so you can do it big if you need a traceable, or you can just print it out on your home printer if you've got a little brush, somebody who wants to project with you, be part of the project. Look, it's a coloring page. I am really uber excited about that. Two ways that we're gonna get this on our canvas. The first way is, I will guide you through the entire drawing process. Second way is, and this is completely honorable, you know what, in art, tracing is a skill. Sorry it is, sometimes you have to trace. There are reasons to trace, and it takes a while to build up rendering skills, no shame in it at all. And again, kind of in the keeping of cowgirl mimosa, I've got one of the rose vector images. I had the roses done separately so you could rose up your trooper. Your trooper as much as you wanted to. Here's how you do this. You print out to the size that you want the image. Use your chalk and just scrape the chalk on the back. You tape the image to your canvas and then with a pencil, just trace your lines, okay? This is all you do. And the reason you tape it is so it doesn't move on you. All right. Now you can use carbon paper if you want to spend some money. And it's very nice. Carbon paper is very nice. This leaves, I don't know if you can see this, hopefully, yeah, I think I can tilt this. This leaves a light little outline on your canvas that you can just draw in, okay? So that's the two ways you can get this on. There is literally no excuse for you not to celebrate the most important holiday of the year. May the 4th be with you, only followed by Revenge of the 5th. Yeah, it's going to be that kind of day because I got a lot of mimosa. I got a lot of mimosa going on and I am enjoying it. So the first thing that I'm going to kind of do is I'm going to pull out my brush, and I have got there, and in this I'm going to use their numbers. You guys know I never use numbers. Why do I never use numbers? Because none of the brush companies agree on numbers, so number 20 is not the same across all brush companies, so I always try to tell you the general width, size, and shape. So no matter what craziness they do, you can find your brush. But this here is the number one round, and then I'm going to get that a little bit wet. And I'm gonna blow your mind with something. Supply, I forgot to mention. My carbon black, this is the fluid acrylic by Golden. I love these, but if it's not in your budget, the folk art paints. For this, one thing, just the black, just this one thing will work. If you can treat yourself to the Golden fluids, it's a fun deal. So you're gonna notice when I drop that out, it's just literally what it says it is. This is when they go, it's a soft-bodied acrylic. Well, what that means is it doesn't have all the heavy body polymers. So yeah, this down here. And I'm going to draw in, actually, no, I'm gonna chalk in. Too much mimosa? Maybe. I'm gonna chalk in what I'm gonna draw in first. So to show you how to draw this in, the first thing that I want you to do is I've got about a hand width from the top and about an inch above my hand from the bottom, and I'm gonna make two little marks. That gives me my general size. And what I'm gonna want you to do is make just a nice oval. Yes, there is a step-by-step. Guys, no worries. There is a step-by-step, okay? Once I have that in, I'm gonna divide this in half. This is super easy to do, don't even stress about it. And I'm gonna come here and I'm gonna make a little upward arc. It's like I'm almost making a football. at first, right? And then I'm going to make this little downward arc. Okay? These little downward facing triangles. Oh, he needs a little trooper band, so I'm going to come across here like this. Now here is the trick on how I get this lower jaw. Circle, circle, circle. I'm going to come out from his mouthpiece, make a little loop, make a little loop, make a little loop. No problem. We're not even worried about that. From the headband, I give him little jowls. I'm sure that is not what Mr. Lucas intended, but that is what it looks like. So that's what we're describing. Little jowls here. I'm going to define a little mouth line right here. So I have that little gas thing that these poor clones were given. I mean, they got a really raw deal, right? Just seriously. And how come they weren't more competent? Because it's like Boba the Fett's dad. Like, they should have been, like, amazing, right? Okay. So that is the base. That is all it takes to draw in. If you were just feeling it, that's all it takes to draw in the basic Stormtrooper, okay? Now the roses, if you don't feel like tracing them in, start with a little curlicue coming down. Then I make a little triangle coming up and a little triangle coming out. Sometimes I will bring a line up that triangle. Up here's another little petal that's layered out. And then on these outer petals, what do? I break up patterns. Come around, but it's still similar. See that little flick out there? Breaking up patterns. Actually easier to paint roses sometimes than draw them. Weird side effect. The bud. Curlicue down, down. Little arc petal comes down here. Little inside petal. Here we go. Bud. And then I'm going to give this some little petals coming out. Now, I'm having some troubles. This particular set, canvas, which I got a hobby of, I'm not liking the stretch on this one. It's loose on the stretcher bars. That's what those little pieces of wood are for inside your package. By the way, when you get the canvas and all these little pieces of wood come out and you're like, what is that for? You hammer those in the grooves, just in case this ever happens to you. You hammer those in these little grooves right here. Boom, boom, boom. Tightens this drum. Another trick to tightening your drum is to spray the back with water. Just stuff I teach you on the Sherpa road. All right, I'm gonna go. We're going. We're having fun today. Dun, dun. All right, so I'm down here. I made my little curlicue. Came down. It's almost like an upside down six, right? Little petal coming around. Another little petal coming out. Oh, I'll fling this little petal out because I like it. Now, I'm going to do a realistic rose class coming up because, again, even easier to paint than to draw. Oh, my gosh. These are almost like a magic trick when you paint them. You're going to love it. Now, let's do a little triangle coming up. Do you see my little triangle there? Little petal. Oh, kind of little wiggly petal. Whew, zoop, zoop. Little petal. Now, again, like I said, the reason I have the traceables is I know this is a drawing here. I've got another petal here and another one here. And I'm going to make a leaf. So how I do the leaf is my leaf will be this long. This will be the bottom. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. I want a little wiggly leaf. Right? Some up here. I may paint these out when I do the yellow ochre because I can put them back in so easily, but if you just need to know where they are, that's where they are, and we'll put the curly cues in later. So we're not doing an acrylic color ground this time, okay? And we kind of are doing an underpainting. So it's a slightly different skill. This is more of a rendered piece, right? For us to impress our friends with. And I realize I don't even need to get into the black yet because I have such a nice line right here that you can see. So I can paint around that fairly easily. So I will get back to my black in a second. I'm going to pull out, and you know how I love these, this half inch. This half inch number 10. Well, no, it's an inch. It's about an inch. It's about an inch. It's got a little hair coming on here. I can always just trim that off if it gets to me. It's got a fairly decent edge. It's got an okay flick back. It's not going to work a real heavy acrylic, but I think for a lot of the stuff that we're doing here, if you need something that's convenient and easy to get to and is a reasonable price and has no stress, like I have my package now and I don't have to think about it again, whoo, it's got you. So I got my brush wet. I'm going to take over a little of my yellow ochre to my white. And as always, for those of you that are new, I never go from the center of my paint pops. I will always work from the outside, and I'm going to make this sort of parchment color. And I'm going to paint everything outside my drawn lines. Okay? Now, new painters, here's what I want you to think about. One of the places that these kind of background paintings will give you is, let's see if I can get this. If you are not covering the canvas, if you're like working and working and working and working and working and working and it's not painting, you don't have enough paint on the brush. I know you think that's insane that I have to say that, but there's so much anxiety and stress sometimes when you start painting that stuff like doing the checklist, is there enough water on my brush? Is there enough paint on my brush? That can actually get away from you. There's nothing wrong with you. I've seen it happen to all kinds of amazing people, even experienced crafters. And it's just about how much anxiety you're feeling, which is what the cowgirl mimosa is for. I love this orange slice, but it's got to go. It can be here, it can be pretty, because I gotta get busy with my mimosa. Honestly, better than champagne. Try it out, it'll blow your mind. I am not advocating any type of drinking. I am advocating life happiness and having something in your life that is special and fun. I am advocating that for sure. So however, that if it's hot cocoa, if you're painting and coloring with your little brush, if they're sitting there right now with a coloring sheet and it's hot cocoa, let it be hot cocoa. But make it special. Guys, make it special. Celebrate all the holidays, especially important ones like Star Wars holidays, because these ones matter. Now, before I hit the fast forward button on this at all, I may not actually, I may make you hang out with me while I paint this whole background in. One of the things I don't want you to worry about, okay, is having just one color on this background. Background is supposed to be multi-tonal. See? So sometimes it should have more white in it. And sometimes it should have more yellow ochre, and it's going to feel like parchment paper. And you're going to love that. It's going to give it a really incredible look. You're going to be so proud to post this up on your social media feeds. Oh my goodness. You know, so proud. I'm so glad to be getting this up. I mean, it is literally the whole reason why I bought my Yoda hat. Of course, the fact that I took it to Dias de los Muertos is because, you know what, when you're a geek that grows up in San Diego and you have all that fantastic influence in everything you do, man, we had weather, Santa Ana, every street, Via de la Valle. I mean, everything was like really, really entangled with our neighbors to the south. It was. And there's just so much of who I am comes from growing up in that entanglement, and I love it. I just love that it's there because I can take all that influence and all those fantastic memories, the flavors, the smells, the people that I knew, and put them into this sort of collaboration, this mashup piece, which is my Day of the Dead Stormtrooper. That's really what I'm doing. This is a story I have in my heart. Because that's how I grew up. With a very multicultural community. And I loved it. I wish I had more appreciation, even as a kid growing up, for how lucky I was. I don't know where your senior ditch day was. Not that you should ever have a senior ditch day. That is very, very, very bad. Actually, I think I'm going to just put my... you can paint around your leaves. I'm just going to paint my leaves back in because that's just easier for me. My senior ditch day was in general in Tijuana. Tijuana used to actually be not... It used to be kind of mellow and wonderful and great. You know, I know sometimes things change over time. So I haven't lived in California in many, many years. Which is why I have Cowgirl Mimosa, because I have been in Texas for so long. But my memories are all good. I got to go to Oaxaca, and I got to go to Mila, Montalban, and have a wonderful time with friends. See how that goes to you? You grow up with... You're there for the first Star Wars, standing in line as a little kid. You cannot even imagine. You think you can now, unless you were there. If you were there, you get it. It was crazy. Nothing like that had ever happened before. Like, not remotely before had anything like that had happened. My parents went to the movies all the time. I went with them to the movies all the time. You know, I'm a little kid. We're going to see this movie. I mean, it could just be like, I had really been drugged through a lot of Benji. I love dogs, and I love the actual dog that was Benji, but Benji movies were rough, right? It was like Bad News Bears, again, love Jodie Foster. But the movies before Star Wars were tough. So here you are in line, and you've never seen a line like this at the movies, right? Ever. Going, what on earth is going on? Like, why are all these people here? And you're thinking, I might not get to see this. Like, it could sell out. And I remember being so grateful we managed to get in. We got in. And I was like, what could it be? And I literally went into the movie theater. And I'm wondering, like, in the comments, tell me if this was your experience. I went into the movie theater, one little kid, and I came out another. And I think that's why we go so banana for everything Lucas has made for us. Is because it was transformative. You know, like this artwork is transformative for us. What he made, it changed the core of my being. No joke. And I know some of you get this. You get how it altered you. His world, the stuff that he created, right? It was amazing. Trooper head. So I'm gonna put this in the water. I'm gonna rinse it out. I always try to rinse these out to the point where my rag is again on the floor. So I will take these paper towels. Not ecologically sound. Okay. So I'm gonna pull this out. All right. Now I'm gonna go ahead and pull in some black lines. Okay. And this is a bit of a coloring project in a sense. I'm going to get that initial brush I was talking about out, but you saw how I just left it in water, which you're never supposed to do. But I've been doing that, and these have hardwood handles. They have a nice coating. They certainly did not immediately pop, and here's what I was really glad they did not do, is shed on the canvas. Sometimes it is hard to find a brush in this price point that does not shed on the canvas. Did I just put my brush in my... I don't care. I'm drinking my mimosa. I did, and I'm still drinking it. That's how good it is. Waste no mimosa. You guys are questioning my mental state, and I'm so excited to share this with you. You're going to be like, what is going on with her? So I'm just going to very carefully outline my shapes here. And all of you are going, wait, how are you getting those wonderful lines? The two things, it is a fluid soft body paint. Obviously my recommendation, if your budget allows for it, is the Golden or even the Liquitex soft bodies or the Matisse Flows. But if you cannot do those, and I totally get that, you should never, ever, ever be made to feel bad. You know, I mean, it's art supplies. It's supposed to be a hobby. It's supposed to bring joy into your life. You know, I know sometimes So there it is. Now, if you have little mistakes, like where I got thick there, and I don't mind letting you guys see that, it's gonna paint out when I paint in the underpainting for this helmet, okay? So don't even be worrying about that. All right, I just want to preserve these lines in a way I can't lose them. And I found when I was designing this that that was a very nice thing to be able to do, was preserve my lines. If somebody makes this into a tattoo, you have got to tell me. But I'm not advocating tattoos in any way. No, I have none. I don't advocate them. It just would be very cool. Okay, so these are those little buttons. All right. And look, if you have a different Stormtrooper head in mind and all I've done is given you the idea, that is okay. That is okay. I just want you guys to have something that you can do with your friends, that you can do with your kids, that you can give, you know, to some person in your life and that they're excited to see. I just want you to enjoy and be excited about art. That's all I want for you. If this is too wet for you to paint on, like you can't rest your wrist, be sure to go ahead and dry it with a hairdryer. And remember, no matter where you're sketching these in, if you see later you're like, oh, I really want to change that, you can totally change that. Don't even stress about it. Okay, this is just paint, and once it's dry, you can alter it. Do you guys love the coloring page? Are you coloring right now? Is somebody coloring right now? I would love if somebody was coloring right now. Okay. Don't draw in with black your circles. We just want this shape. Because I did some different designs. This is not historically researched, spiritually accurate Day of the Dead celebration imagery. This was just what sort of came out of my stream of consciousness into my heart and what I felt like putting into the world. But you can absolutely go as deep as you want to. You can. What can you do? You can geek out. You may geek out on the whole thing and really find patterning and everything that is very reflective of that. All right, so I'm going to put this in here. And I'm going to take that half inch brushing, not half inch, I say half inch because I'm so used to the one inch angle brush, get a little blue, get a little white, and some black. And yes, guess what? You can mix fluids. If you didn't know, you can mix fluids. Look at that color I made there. You can mix fluids with heavy bodies. Yeah. You can mix the golden opens. And if you're ever wondering if a paint can do something, if it's a good company, if it's one of the big companies I'm always talking about that care about, you're going to be drawing in these lines again, so don't get all attached too much to what's happening. You just put them in so that you have a reference point, so that you don't lose your design work here. Okay, see, I'm hanging this in. See this right here? Now I'm making sure that I'm covering up all the white canvas, which a lot of times what we do that acrylic color ground for is so that the white canvas does not show through underneath. But what we've got here is almost an underpainting. So we want different tones. We don't want one whole tone showing through the canvas, peeking out. We want different tones. I'm going to put this back in water. I'm going to get a new brush. Because guess what else they have? And I want a little tighter space, a little more control. What else do I love in the universe of brushes? Well, I love brights and I love filberts. Right? I mean, and look at this here. Look, you've got several sizes of detail rounds, which I'm always suggesting to you. You've got brights. They're a longer bristle bright, but you've got brights. You've got a great bright here. This is exactly what I'm talking about all the time. And another natural bristle. You've got this for washes, for clouds, for varnishing. You've got another small, tight filbert. You have this hair lining brush. you have this little filbert, you have this other great, there's just so much selection that you can just be like, do I feel tight? Do I feel cramped? You know, and change it out. If you're not loving the experience, go ahead and change out the experience. That's all you've got to do. What you need out of a brush is a quality product that gives you a consistent result that you can predict and does not shed all over your crazy canvas, and also does not break your bank. Because you might see a brush and be like, did that thing say $120? Seriously? I was real happy with the coupon they were talking about giving you guys. It was going to give you guys such a deep discount on these brushes. And they're full price on Amazon. It's not crazy expensive. It's best to buy them directly through them, even on Amazon, if you want that guarantee. If you want the lifetime guarantee, you know, definitely go through them so that they can do that. Because I think anytime a company wants to do that, they are a mom and pop company. They decided to go into brush making. I have been talking to Chloe, their rep, who's fantastic. I really like her. And here's what I like. She kept talking about the customer experience. And so that's what I want to hear back from you if any of you guys decide to go ahead and pull the trigger on these. Is, are you getting a good customer experience? Are you being treated well? I have been treated very well, but you know, I am doing a YouTube show here. Well, I am being treated very well. But I want to make sure you guys are being treated very well. And I liked what they had there. I liked the resources that they had. I noticed some of the other YouTubers have used these brushes and enjoyed them. I got paid no money. It was just given a set of brushes. I am not paid to say any of this. And I don't know. I suppose there... I'm pretty hard to sense. I'm not even sure there's an amount of money that takes away my opinion, you know. Like, on a pro level, if I was doing big canvases for show and just acrylics, these wouldn't be ideal or perfect for me because they don't have enough stiffness. It's not quite the perfect combo. But then I drop a crazy, you know, even on my creative marks, it's still a good amount of money. And, you know, this was economical, competitively economical, oh my goodness, compared to some that I've seen out there. And still going to give you a good result. I was so happy to see that. Because I was so afraid I was going to have to write back and go, oh God, no. Oh no, I can't talk about it because all the bristles fell out. I was really afraid. Because here's the crazy thing I did. I went to the pop-up show with no backup brushes. What was I thinking, guys? Like, I didn't test these out. I, like, had them in the package, unopened. I opened it at the show. I was like, what is my real experience? I could have just driven out there and been like, I will be painting this painting today with my fingers. Gosh, I hope it sells and works out. I don't know if you guys ever get out of the house like that where you didn't think everything out as completely as you could. And now you're going to be paying for it. And right now you're going, Sherpa. Dear Sherpa.
Sherpa.
Troopers are white. Painting them blue. Oh, I'm not going to subject you to my Yoda. My Yoda is like the worst. I don't know why I never got a good beat on doing a Yoda. Everybody else did. I did dress up my pony's Tauntaun. I certainly played some Star Wars in my life. You know, how is your May the 4th be with you going? All my Jedis, because you're not just artists today, you're Jedis. You're art Jedis, and the midichlorians are coming from the painting into you and back, and, you know, you're feeling the Force. Now I'm going to have fun. I'm going to get a smaller little brush and get control over my detail result. There is these nice little storage things here, which I really like. When I clean and put them all away, I have to say I love that. If you did not want brushes everywhere, you had space concerns, I thought that might also be really, really nice. because I have like the giant buckets of endless brush, but you know, if you're in an apartment or somewhere and you had space issues, that could be really not cool. Right? Really, really not cool. Come back and reline this. Now you could have painted everything so carefully that so you don't have to, but I'm kind of like this crazy person and I get it in and then I work it out as I go. That's a lot of my art things. I get it in, I get her done. Get her done. Then I work it out and then I tighten it up because that's what I like. Now you'll notice some of the black wasn't dry yet. That's another thing that I've noticed of the fluids. They won't necessarily dry as fast. Don't worry about that, because what is this? This is an underpainting. So it's like a, it's like that acrylic color ground, but a little more thought out. And what it's gonna do is give you depth and layers, right? You can tighten this up if you had areas that you had issues with it. You just wanna know where your shapes are. I'm gonna get my Just Black. Even though I know I'm coming here and I'm cleaning up these lines. Even though I'm coming here and I know I'm cleaning up these lines. Yeah? Alright, just feeling that. I just want to get that first layer. Now, if you are having an experience and really want to talk about this with your canvases, especially in the 16 by 20 range, that from one canvas to the next, it feels like you just bought from a whole different canvas company. You are not alone. It is something I am seeing a lot of. You will not see in the higher end canvases, but then you don't get the big packages of two for this amount of money or five for this amount of money. And apparently the cost of getting them down for the sip and paints has been somewhat of a cost and quality or oversight. There is no oversight in the art world. Again, I say it on the brushes. You'll see my supply list. I talk about inches, not numbers, even though all the brushes are numbered, because those little kookadooks won't get together and have like some sort of brush summit and go, you know, we should unify brush sizes. So a size 20 brush in my company is the same as a size 20 brush in your company. That would be fantastic, wouldn't it? I would love that. You know, at this point, I'm going to have to go get my own little line of brushes and my own little line of everything, I swear. And then I'll have a standard size. It should make sense, too. Like, it should be like millimeter. It should be some sort of standard expected size. Now, I'm going to go back to my nice little detail. I love doing this. I don't know why I've been into crossing my eyes lately. I'm going to go back to the details. I'm going to get my detail brush, which was the number one. Now, in size, this is not hyper detail. This is not a totally fine detail. This is like a small detail. So there's medium and small and extra small. And mostly I'm dealing with medium, small, and extra small in my painting. Like this here, this would be like the extra small. And this is like a small, okay, just to give you size comparisons. I'm going to, what do you bet, you know what's coming, I'm going to line up my roses to get that black in, okay? While I'm here, I'm gonna line up my roses to get a nice black lining in. Look at me coming up here. How do I get these fine lines? Besides having a nice tip, this brush has a very nice, sharp tip. Besides the fact that this brush is well built, how do I get this? Well, there's the fluidity of my paint, which I can either buy a paint that is fluid, okay, or I can make it fluid by adding water or medium to it, okay. But another thing that I do is I rest my wrist, which is why you saw my canvas move. I rest my wrist. And I use a very light pressure, because a light pressure gives me a thin line, heavy pressure gives me a thicker line. Light pressure, thin line, heavy pressure. Guess what? You can warm up on a scratch piece of paper, for sure. For sure. For sure. So hopefully you've enjoyed however you got the Stormtrooper on the canvas. I really hope some people do this. I'm so excited to see these paintings because I know a lot of the artists, I know a lot of the regular artists are, they're sort of from the same geek community I'm from, and we all watch Doctor Who, and we all watch Star Wars, and we all watch Star Trek, and we just enjoy all this stuff. I mean, like, I was literally born and bred to watch Game of Thrones. It is in my DNA. I have geekdom both sides of the family. Totally both sides of the family. And that is awesome. I'm actually really proud of that. I don't even know what normal is. I don't believe there actually is such a thing as normal. I think that's something people who are one way sell to another group of people to sort of sell themselves off as normal. In my experience, everybody's sort of crazy and odd and ticky. And life is about learning to just be forgiving of that. And just be like, even if they're stressing you out, just take a knee. Just take a knee. Blow it out. And be like, you know what? Today was their day to be crazy. Tomorrow it might be my day to be crazy. I'm going to put my leaves back in. But if you had painted around them, then you would just black line them right now. But you can kind of see how I do this right here. You guys seeing this all right? I'm going to do one here that you can really see. We're having trouble. Like, we tried the up-close camera on the... Just... What I need is to have a cameraman in here zooming in. And that's the thing that I just don't really have. So hopefully you guys are getting enough information from this experience to be able to do these paintings. Here's another trick. Watch here at the palette. I'm going to roll and pull the brush. Sometimes the brush will load weird, and that's how you get it clear. Just one of those weird things that years of painting will teach you to do. Right? That you might not know to do if you were new. All these weird little scrubs and pulls and rolls. That is the muscle memory that comes over time. That's why I'm like, art is a skill that you're learning, and you learn this skill. I'm looking forward to the realistic rose episode. I'm looking forward to the florals. Come by the Facebook page. Come by the web page. Come by Pinterest. Share what you're doing. Tell me about your lives. What's going on? What's happening? What's happening? What's your art experience? What art supplies did you buy that you were excited that you got? Let's celebrate that. I might put this little thing here. I'm going to let it be over him this time because that's how weird I am. I'm going to come down here and just tell me about what's going on for you. I want to know. I am doing my best to keep up and comment, but I do read everything. Some days all I can do is like. Some days all I can do is get by and read. Some days all I can do is manage to get filming so you guys have something new. But there's really no day that I'm not thinking about you. And what art is meaning to you guys. Because I know in your lives it's a big deal. So share that with me. Don't feel weird. Send me pins on Pinterest. Like, you see stuff that you like and you're excited about. I won't copy another artist's work. Because I really love artists. And I'm not one of those places that says, I love artists. Let me steal all your stuff and profit from it. Which is not what you guys are doing when you paint something and then sell it to your friends or family or a local show. This is more like a Bed Bath & Beyond was to be like, and they never have. They're very good. They're very responsible in the licensing department. But a big giant company were to take my artwork without my permission and run with it. That would be like, not cool. What you guys do when you paint it and you show it and you put it on your little Etsy stores, you sell it to your friends and family, it's okay. Do it. That's fine. That is okay, you know. But I am respectful of, like, artists out there that are making their money at it, you know. But if there's a style or there's a feeling or there's a subject that you're in love with, you know, tell me about it. Because that's how I decide what I'm doing. Yes, sometimes I do geek out and I take you guys on a ride like this where we create a mashup holiday for some of my favorite holidays. Sometimes I do that to you. But I do try to listen to you. I do pay attention to everything that you're saying, everywhere that you're saying it, and I will never get so big that I don't read the comments. That is just not who I am. And hopefully if I was that big, I could afford to have someone help me with everything so that you guys could stay in touch, you know. But that's definitely what the Sherpa app is for. I'm so glad that's going to be coming out soon. And if this is a really old video, if it's like 5 years after launch, go by the website and check and see what's going on with the Sherpa app, because I'm sure by then it'll be awesome. I sometimes forget that these last way beyond when I post them. Like, I'm all excited right now that there's a new Star Wars movie coming, and I don't know how I feel about it. And I'm like, I don't know if I'm okay with a new director doing it, or if I feel like it has to be Lucas. And I know everybody's like, I'm letting this dry for a second. I know everybody is like, not sure if they like the last three, which were the first three in that weird Lucas kind of way. And I'm up for all of it. I'm willing to survive Ewoks and Jar Jar Binks and just buy into everything this man has for me, because I believe he creates from such an open-hearted, loving place. I mean, he's really contributing to the world being kinder and more beautiful. Look at the stuff he makes. It's about the world being kinder and more beautiful. How awesome is that? How fantastic. So I have those in. I'm going to add some more leaves. Now that I've had my weird soapbox of I love Lucas. He doesn't know me at all. Has no idea who I am and will likely never know who I am. It's like all the people I love. It's just like, I love Lisa Vanderpump. Lisa Vanderpump is never going to stop by and paint a Star Wars sugar skull. That's not happening. But I love her. I do. Put my little leaf back. And I feel like I want another little leaf here. See, that's how I get that crazy thin line is, I swear, when we do the little swirls, you're going to be like, how do you do that? And I'm going to be like, it's just pressure. Under pressure. If you need more paint, put out more paint. If you need to thin some more paint, thin some more paint. I had a girlfriend, like, I know what it's like to have to think about the budget. She actually wrote me just recently, and she's going to be like, wait, you better not be talking about me, but I'm totally talking about you. So she writes me, and she's like, what's something I can use just at home around the house for varnish? And I'm completely grinding my brain going, like, everything in the Middle Ages was, like, handmade, and I know something about that because I used to do medieval reenactment. Yeah, I'm totally owning that right now. Totally, totally owning being in the SCA and absolutely doing that. Anyway, so I was in this thing called Scribal, which is kind of obvious, which is the art. And, of course, we do things like rabbit skin glue or making parchment. First thing about all art materials on how they're actually made, they're crazy poisonous, they smell a bunch, and you do not have those ingredients in your refrigerator. So I'm like, let me look it up. So I look it up, and I send her this link, and I'm like, I don't know, you got some gelatin. And then it turns out that she had some other varnish from another thing that would totally work. But, you know, you just don't think about how easy it is for us to have paint. Like, I'm not training with pirates. Literally, there was a time in art you had to trade with pirates to get colors. And sometimes they ripped you off. Not kidding. So things that are now white were maybe originally red. It's really interesting. Art history is actually interesting history. It's an intense history class, but it is an interesting history class because you really get a sense of trade and global economies, and like the story of the Conti Crown is an insane story, and is about, like, hey, you couldn't get any lead, the ability to write on paper that wins wars. So I'm just cleaning some of this up. Okay, it's a good time to do it. We're gonna clean this up. Now you could clean this up after the white. But I want to avoid the edges here a little bit and create that sort of craft look. So that's why I'm doing it now. you know, and I'm just trying to guide you through this. Gosh, guys, I hope you paint these. I hope you paint a bunch of them. I hope you show, oh, if your kid colors from the coloring page, you've got to share it on Facebook or on the webpage. You've just got to. You've just got to. I will just die. I will just be so pleased, and I will just die. I'll just die. Not for real. I'll keep posting videos and teaching. You know what I mean? That would just, I just totally was my artist, Chuck Carson, who helped me do those, who hand digitizes it, which means he has to translate my crazy design bits that I send over to him into reasonable digital sketches that are vectored and can be large enough that you just send light and love to Chuck Carson, the digital Sherpa, and just send him light and love, because he just makes so much of what you guys love on Heart Party Grill, the step-by-steps, and the pinnables are really from his heart, and you just have no idea what a nice, nice man he is. He's kids, he gets it. So we are really excited to create that coloring page. The coloring page. Yay! And the traceable, so you could trace it as well. I mean, that was the other reason to do it. So if you're just not feeling like, you know, I don't really like to draw. It's not fun for me. I really like the painting part. I don't like the drawing part. Carbon paper, blow it up, trace it on, right? No, nothing wrong with that. I want you guys to get results that you were not only felt good about, but we're not stressed in getting, right? Not stressed. You know, another cool thing that you could do is once you like learn this, you could just take a Stormtrooper helmet and like spray it with a good primer for plastic and then make a sugar skull on that, right? Would that not be amazing? Amazing! I bet you're so glad that you can pause and fast forward me right now. So in this particular one, I've just chosen to layer some of the bolt behind the rose because I didn't in the original, but I like it here. Now you could, my eyes are not as sharp or deep black as I'd like them to be for what I'm about to do later. you know, please tell me what you think, you know, in the comments. Just remember that it's a family show and kids are here. And so, like, you know, say anything you need to say in your heart. Just make sure that it's, if you have some, you know, actually, everyone has been really positive. I don't want to borrow any negativity because, honestly, the whole community has been positive. People have asked good questions. They've been so respectful and kind. And I really just enjoyed meeting all of you. I love meeting the other YouTubers, too, that come by and subscribe where you've got channels. Hey, other YouTubers. I think you're awesome. I love your craft channels. I love your multimedia channels. I love your art journaling channels. I love your I Got a Wedding Project channels. I love your channels about pecans and green smoothies. I love your channels about living off the grid, Starry Hilder High. I love your channels. And of course, you know, my mom's channel and my mom's channel. I love your channels. If you've got a YouTube channel and you're an artist, you want to reach out to me, I am so cool. Do it. Reach out to me. I think what we do is amazing. I think it's time to change my water. It's getting a little yucky. So I have always got backup water. I'm just going to leave these over here for a second. And I like my backup water. I'm going to put it here. It's drinky, drinky poo time. Cowgirl nomos. I'm serious. If you're right now going hard cider and orange juice, better than champagne, better than Moscato, like the only thing that could make this better is if it was in a red Solo cup. This is my first one, though. I had a lot of coffee earlier today, and I always really get excited on my sort of geekier days. My next brush that I'm going to grab, from this awesome package that I really appreciated getting. And I have to say, these guys are really brave for just sending this to me and hoping that I would be, like, cool about it. That was... Because, I mean, I wouldn't have, like, posted something like I hated it, but you have some faith in your product. Notice I didn't go in the water, guys. Notice I didn't go in the water here. I'm getting some just white paint. And here is what I'm going to do. I'm going to dry brush. See if I can get really up close so you guys can see this, so I don't have a zoom in camera. All right. This is where I use a very light pressure. The color underneath is showing. Can you guys see that? I think you can. I'm trying to get just white. You gotta find one little clean spot of white. It's okay if you get a little color in it. It is okay. Hey, here's a trivia question, and then it's not Star Wars. What do you gotta do at the end of your acrylic painting? Varnish it. There's a link. Go to it, learn how to varnish it. At the end, I do end cards to other videos that you can see. Sometimes my husband, if he's feeling like it, will put in like outtakes. I don't know if on this video, we've been having a lot of computer. I intend and believe that my computer will be okay. I'm not even going to talk about what's going on. I mean, intend it will. He's been having to, we've had some remote and we're doing things on the laptop, and it's been a little crazy. I know you guys have been like, you're getting so many videos out. You have no idea, like, what it's taken. I feel like Egyptians, like, chipping away. So hopefully I will be on something new and it's going to be, like, completely glitch-free and I will be getting this up. I'm, like, painting this right now. Actually, I'm going to pull a little of this just white to the side so I have it for just the dry brushing. I'm painting this right now with just a belief that it'll be okay. That is what it is. So you see how that... See if it can focus on that. Can you see how that is? Right there. Sometimes I use my fingers to see if I can get it to focus. That is the look that we are going for. And that is another area where your piece will not look like other pieces. This painterly, see how I'm doing it here? I'm just sort of taking the edge of this bright and pulling it down, edge of the bright and pulling it down. That is why a sharp bright matters, is because you can get these crisp edges. If you paint out a black line, guess what? Let it dry, paint it back in. You know, have fun with this. This is like you're making an adult coloring book. Yeah, that's a thing now, by the way, guys. And no, I don't mean like adult, I mean like adult, like it's a complicated, ornate coloring book is super in right now. That's the other reason I'm really excited to give you guys coloring pages, because I think that's a fun thing to add to it. I don't know what will happen with that. It's sort of like Chuck and I are adding that to our enormous crazy to-do list that we are barely getting through. And if you follow the channel, you know my husband's real busy, like crazy busy, trying to get the Sherpa app made. And you're like, what, do you need an app? Wait till you see. Oh my God, Becky. Oh my God. It is like the best app ever. If you love art and you love creativity and you like being connected to kind people that are art supportive, if you want to be up on things early, if you want to know like insider tips of places to paint, I mean, like, it's crazy. What it will do will blow your minds. Really, really, really. And hey, if there's something like you hear that and you think an app, well, gosh, I really wish an art app would have this. That would make me feel really, just put it in the comments, because I'm gonna listen to you more than anything else. Isn't it nice you can fast forward me? Just don't have to listen to everything I have to say. And you won't even know there was an app. But see, if you had the app, then it wouldn't matter if you fast-forwarded me, because you would be up on everything that's important. Plus, there's badges. Just say. And missions. There's art missions. And they're not sucky, they're really fun. All right, I'm gonna come here and I'm gonna, again, use the brush to my advantage to create that sharp edge and get the white in here. And again, come back when we're doing the ornate black lining, clean up any air lines that are bugging you. Now, on occasion, you may have to add a little water to it, even on a dry brush. Just don't add a lot. Does it shock anyone else? Like, sometimes it freaks me out that I can talk to you. Like, I know that you're there while I'm filming, but, like, essentially in reality and functionality, there's nothing going here. But I'm totally, like we're... It just trips me. And my kids think I'm insane. They're like, are you talking to yourself again? Mom? Don't talk to yourself. There's no one in the studio with you. Who are you talking to? I think that's what makes us YouTubers kind of a wonderful, crazy group of people, is we're like time travelers. We're speaking to people who are not even there yet, but we know we're there. And if you are going to give me the gift of your time, which is precious, I am going to give you the gift of mine for sure. How you guys loving the channel lately? All stuff going on with it. Can you believe how many lessons we are throwing up? It's a completely new world. I know we don't have as many like crazy little funny outtakes and things within the videos, but I am doing a lot of my own editing now so that the stuff, you know, so that we can keep up, which I'm really excited that I learned editing. Like, I'm super proud of myself, you know, and that is the thing, right? You're never at a place in your life that you can't take on a new thing. It's never the end. It's always, look at me, I'm so crazy. I'm just like doing it. I'm just like, hey, let's be on YouTube. Hey, let's learn how to edit. Hey, let's learn how to do social media. Hey, let's just learn how to do all of it. Why not? Why aren't your dreams, right? Why not your dreams? Why not? George Lucas said, why not? When he went to make this movie, no one thought it was a good idea. Oh my gosh, were they all completely wrong? I mean, when you see Carrie Fisher or Harrison talking about it, and they're talking about how, or Mark Hamill, like, nobody thought it was going to do anything, and they didn't know what was in his head, and nobody had ever seen anything like it before. Yeah. Well, they learned, didn't they? They learned. The guy composing the soundtrack, like, he had no idea he was about to be like one of the most famous music composers of all time. Like, none. Nobody thought anyone could take science fiction that seriously. And honestly, and this is, okay, and Trekkies, do not go bananas on me. Okay, because I totally grew up with Trek, and I respect the Trek, but Star Wars, the way it legitimized all science fiction, that was where that came from. Because regular people, because non-geeks loved it, and it legitimized all of it. Like, it paved the ground for the Star Trek franchise to come back, or Doctor Who to be revitalized. I mean, this is where it came from, because people took it so seriously, and they were like, all walks of life, they cared so much. Trekkies, do not go bananas on it, okay? I love Trek. I love Roddenberry. And I think Roddenberry, if you got him in a room, would be like, yeah, that was wonderful. Like, most artists who appreciate what other artists do, I think you'd be like, it is great what it did for all, like, we would not be watching Game of Thrones right now going, what is happening with Daenerys? Would you please get your dragons? And I mean, seriously, if that girl doesn't go get the dragons out of that hole, and I'm not going to say anymore because I'm not a spoiler of shows if you're a couple episodes behind, but I have a lot of feelings on what's happening with Daenerys and the dragons. But it's making me really, really crazy. But I won't say anything because you might not be where I'm at. See, because I'll talk to you like we're totally like I know you really well, because some of you I know really well, but then I got to remember there might be 30,000 of you that I don't know at all yet, but that you're going to subscribe to the page, and you're gonna follow, and you're gonna tweet, and you're gonna pin, right? Okay, so look at how that looks. All right, very, very, very crafty. Rinse your brush out. Rinse, 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 rinse. Why am I dropping all of my paper towels on the floor? Don't say it's the mimosa, because I will have no one diss the mimosa. Oh my God, you guys have to tell me if you make it and you love it as much as I do, because I am not advocating any particular anything. I'm just saying yum. That's all I'm saying. I'm gonna take my purple over to my cad red, or maybe my cad red over my purple, depending on whatever's easier. You do whatever's easier. And I'm gonna make this sort of fleshy purple, technical term. And I'm going to paint in, I've still got this filbert here, this smaller filbert. I'm gonna paint in my roses with this dark color. I'll be as careful of the lines as I can be. Careful of the lines as I can be. I'm worried this episode is gonna be longer because there's so much rendering. And also because I'm so chatty today. So hopefully you can get through it with me. I hope you can. But you know what? If you're like, got it, I can paint it, you don't need to listen to me. You do not need to hear my feelings on Game of Thrones, which you should be watching if you're not watching. Really should be. I'm just going to paint everything that's white with my purple. Okay, guys? Roses are dark
and deep.
Roses are dark and deep. So the first color here that I've got to do, and when I show you guys how to do a realistic rose, this will be true too, is about this first color. Okay. See that? Full lesson. I may fast forward some of this. I don't know. I may just let you. Sometimes I like to let you guys be in charge of what you skip. It's like there's a part of me that's like, man, I should just fast forward all of this. But it's so easy for you guys to skip and be in charge. And I never want to not be there for that one person that needs every brushstroke. That's really what it is. It's so tempting to YouTube it up and make it short and then you remember, but I gotta be there for that one person. Those two, you know, and it's not really one person, it's actually a lot of people, because a lot of people process art very differently, and they process in this very particular ordered manner, and it's not fast, and they really want to see everything, and that's how their brain works. And it's just rude to just be like, oh well, you don't get it the way you need it, we're going to satisfy a whole nother group of people. And I just think to make it where, notice here, I'm not even having to be that careful with my black lines, because the pigment load, whatever I've got here, is fairly thin because of the water and the way I thinned it out. I'm able to sort of glaze and not have to be as concerned about my black lines. How cool is that? Something you wouldn't have known if you fast forwarded, but I don't care if you do. I'm not offended at all. You make the show what you need it to be. It is about you and your art journey and the places that you're going with your art. I'm all good. I get to make a YouTube show with my friends and share my artwork with people that I like and meet people from all over the world. Yes, I love the country shout outs. Yes, I do. I love when somebody's like, hey, from the Netherlands. That's so cool. Or, oh, Prague. Shouting out. Or, it's France. I just love all of that. You know? And even if there's like a language barrier, I love when people like completely try to overcome it. Thank goodness for Google Translate. That's how I answer back in other countries' languages. I'm like, Google Translate, help me out. Let's get these all in. You have no idea how hot it is in the studio. But I love my I'm not giving it up. Mm-mm. I have hair. Just so y'all know, I have it. But there's nothing wrong if you do not. My aunt had alopecia from the time she was a teenager on, which is how, in a weird way, my husband ended up on Extreme Makeover. Google that. Bunch of craziness. Yes, I just said that. Yes, he did. He donated all of his hair to Locks of Love, and a lot of that came from seeing what she went through and wanting to be there for other young girls that were going through that. I love Locks of Love. Again, they're probably not watching this, but they're wonderful. Amazing, amazing, amazing place. And so we got to really be part of something incredible and bring attention to something incredible. So don't let anything make you feel bad. Don't do it. If I didn't, I would just show you, because I wouldn't want you to ever feel bad about being who you are. Because who you are is exactly perfect. You were made perfect for your role in the world. You're made how you needed to be. No mistake. That's why you're not really making mistakes in art. I think Bob really understood that. If you're painting, you're winning. If you're painting, you are winning and defining and discovering yourself. He's great. And changing it up. All right? Changing it up. And no, guys, it doesn't bother me when you share paintings from other channels. Don't you hear that? There's a sitter out there, so the little squeal will be addressed. It's the dog when she barks startles my daughter. And the dog just loves, like, if a pedestrian goes by the front window, the dog is just like, yes! We'll tell them all about how they are not allowed in here without permission. That's what she does. All right, the leaves, which is going to start out cad yellow and blue to a very dark green. What we're making. Weird little trick. You want to make it a darker green? Shock, add a little cad red to it. How crazy is that, right? And then just go ahead and paint in your leaves. You can always come back and re-white line out. So this is a little bit like coloring. If you want on the original design that was the basis for what I'm doing, right? We keep what we do here, but the design pieces, when I'm working out, hey, what am I going to teach on the show? I put those on Etsy. So if you want to see those, pin those, buy those are there. Everything is acceptable. Just go by and be like, I like it. I'm going to put it in a treasury. That's fine. It's all fine. I'm not worried about any of it. It will all work itself out in time. How's that looking? How are you loving it? Longer lesson than usual. But, you know, we're all good. I think we're going to be coming in right at 2. Which is okay. I mean, that's not really that unreasonable. That would be like a 7 paint. I'm going to get my green, and I'm going to put it on that to detail the round number 1 maestro detail. Notice that these have been sitting in water, and they're not giving me any grief. You shouldn't do that with your brushes, though, but I'm not getting any grief. And I really think that for those of you that are really hopping channel to channel and doing project to project and Pinter testing and having a bunch of different mediums, this may be a very good solution for you. So again, let me know what you think. Okay, when I have the brush loaded up, we have a nice amount of paint loaded up. I'm going to do this shocking thing. Why do I do that? So that it's oriented at my most comfortable space, because I don't want to be uncomfortable. right? And there's my little one. They make noise. That's what they do. So you just make these little curlicues. That's what I like to do. Little curlicues. See how I did those? I'll show you again right here. So I'm going to just come here. This is about very light pressure, and I don't worry about like that much about the line. I worry more about the feeling of it, right? So if I were to come here, I'm going to come up and curlicue. Right? It's a fun thing to practice. Curlicue. That'll be a little different every time I do it. Curlicue. All right, so we have those sort of ornamental pieces there. Are you with me? And I'm liking that. And I'm about to get my Dia de las Muertas on. Okay, who loved that cartoon, Day of the Dead? Was that just awesome or what? Book of the Dead, Book of Life. It's like the Kilroy thing, I swear. In the moment when I'm here and I'm filming and then I'm like, fuck my brain, boop. It's not this. Nothing. Only good comes from this cup. I'm done with champagne. I am. I am all about cider and orange juice. Did I lose my... Excuse me. Okay, same detail brush. And we're going to start putting in some designs, okay? So a lot of this is going to be about putting things where they don't bother you. And the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to do the rising sun. So I'm going to make a half moon or a half circle between the eyeballs. Okay. You can clean up anything here you feel like you need to clean up. All right. And then I'm going to do a little wavy line like this. If you printed out a traceable, you can just go ahead and skip this whole thing and trace it in and then paint it in. You know, you can get those done at any size, like at Kinko's or any place that has printing services. So you can size those to any canvas. If you're painting with the kid, definitely do it. Don't make them work too hard. That's like a little rough on them. All right, come here. You know, however strong you want those lines, do it. You'll find that they work out no matter what. Now I'm gonna do a crazy thing. I think I'm gonna do some clouds this time. See how I did that there? I just made those sort of fluffy shapes. For purposes of time, we're going to maybe do less of the little lines and everything up here. We'll do some of them, but not all of them. That way you guys aren't so overwhelmed. Sometimes I'll do that from an original design. I'll be like, dude, we gotta just chillax. We gotta just chillax up here. All right. The other thing I want you guys to think about is just make it your own. Now I'm gonna do a cool thing. I'm gonna go V, 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 V. I think that'll look really cool. Why do I do this? Because I'm an artist, that's why. I might actually just come up this side with the lines here. Again, you could do your own thing. This is your skull head. You'd have a flower up here. You could have daisies. Stormtrooper a la daisy. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I think that's a nice pattern up on the head. I like that today, and I'm happy with that, right? Then, okay, I'm going to very carefully make an arced. This is going to be real important. If you're doing this for a Star Trek fan in your life, this arced part is going to be important to them. So right in the middle, I'm going to make an arch. This implies a very important part of the Stormtrooper's helmet that we're going to completely, completely be strange about. You go ahead and make this as ornate as you want. Okay. And then I make a little check. I come down and make a little check. Come down and make a little check. That's what I did. Now I'm going to make a circle right between the eyes. I don't know if that's a little derivative since I've got a circle up there design-wise, but that's what's happening. And I'm going to sketch in, where I put my pencil, right here, with pencil first, because it'll get painted out. I'm going to sketch in that star. You know how to do a star, that star thing that you do. And then you can paint in. Hopefully it will help you. It may not have helped me that much. This is not my strongest suit. And that's good for you to see too sometimes, is that things are not perfect on my end. I may have to do the actual star thing just to get it right, and then I'll just paint it later. See? And that's good for you guys to know. I work things out. Mistakes happen in my painting. Sometimes I'm painting and I'm like, what was I thinking? You know? And I also like the little sort of Grecian olive little things that I had going off there. So I do the two little lines there. And I make these like little leaves coming like this. Sort of reminds me of the Olympics. I'm not comparing Greece to the Empire. I'm just being decorative. There's no, sometimes in art there's really deep symbolism, and sometimes, even if there is, it's not that deep. You're just kind of like, oh, it was just fun to do. Okay. And I'm going to make scallops along the eyes with a drop here and more scallops along the eyes. Just scallops. All right, you see that there? What am I really making for myself? In a sense, I'm making a coloring book, right? Because I'm going to come back in with my detail brush and I will color these pages. The other thing is, like, you will get wound up in, like, is this line perfect? And I won't. And so I'll end up with a complete painting. And when the whole picture is together, it will look awesome and it will feel awesome. And you guys will do this thing. You're like, oh, that line is a little bit to the left and I really wanted it to be just an eighth of a millimeter or possible micron to the right, and the whole thing is off. And it's not. It's just you're having a moment. So just go. It's not about perfection, even though perfectionism is awesome. It is about completion. So you're going to want to finish the piece, and then you paint it all in, and then when it's all in, it's just beautiful. It works out in the end. Everything just sort of works out in the end. You're just scalloping along, and you scallop that. Then I really liked this sort of like up-down zigzag on the upper part of the nose, and that just sort of came up on this part. I just thought it was like neat decoratively. And again, I'm not like, you know, in this particular instance, this isn't digital art, and I'm not being crazy precise. I could be as precise as I wanted. I could T-square out, and I can make sure everything is very, very symmetrical and even and reflective. And if that makes your soul happy, just ignore what I'm doing and do it your way. Don't, like, do something that makes your art soul unhappy. Just don't do it. So the other thing I like to do is I like to add some leaves to this. So first I add these little flick outs that I'm going to attach the leaves to. That's how I do those. First I just, and then I just put some leaves on there, which is just this little diamond shape. This is a piece that would look good in a lot of media. You could do this piece in watercolor. You could do this piece in pens. You could do this piece in pencil because of the nature of it, because of the way it is, it's gonna come across really well. You could do this piece in paper mache. I mean, they're just really, it just, I don't know about oils, maybe oils. You know. It's fun to do the leaves. I like doing all the leaves. Right. And then I want something decorative down here. So I'm going to do a little drop, 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 drop. So I've created like this little flower shape. All right, and then I'm gonna come and make a little squiggle. A little squiggle here. Now I could make a little finish that off in a drop. And anytime I finish a squiggle off at the drop, then I get to color it, is what gets to happen. And that's super fun. All right, so he's got that going on. All right, and fun thing I can do, one of the other fun things that you can do is you can do dots. Don't forget the power of a dot to create a pattern. So dots made in rows can create implied lines, beautiful texture, and add a whole element or dimensionality to a piece. So this can apply to more than what you're doing today. I would love to see this introduce you guys to a set of art skills. They got you a little imaginative. They got you thinking about, what can I mash up? What art things can I be creative about today that, you know, that tells a story about my world? So I'm gonna make a little half circle here and a little half circle here, and then I'm gonna do little petals. Petals. You guys still with me? Because we still gotta color this sucker in. Petals. Isn't it good you can just pause and come back the next day? You can just pause and come back the next day if you're like, oh my gosh, I had no idea that this little squiggly, little stormtrooper was gonna take the rest of my life. Like, I'm gonna be done with this when the movie comes out. That's when I'm gonna be done with my storm. And that is okay to be like, I gotta see you tomorrow, Sherpa. Give me a couple of days. Me and the girls will get back together, make our cowboy gnomoses tomorrow again, and because they're so economical. Because in the country, we make do. That's how you discover stuff like that out here. Really? Like, you don't have champagne and all you got left is your husband's hard cider and you're like, man, I just would really love something special. You just combine them up and then you discover that there's something better to add to orange juice than champagne. I have no deals with the hard cider. I'm not like Bethany Frankel, who is awesome. Awesome, love her, awesome. Bethany Frankel is fantastic. Like her so much. To the degree that you agree with Bethany Frankel, you are right. Ramona Singer. I'm talking about people on reality TV. Like they're real. Because that's how I think. All right, so woo! Look at that. Whole upper half of the face. Dun, 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 dun. Now the next little thing we're gonna do, we're gonna finish off the bottom and you're gonna be like, oh, yes. So if you can remember where those circles were, I'm going to make another little circle here. It's important to the trooper construction, and another little circle here. And I'm going to turn these into flowers, but first I'm going to make this little exhaust shape right here. You see this sort of little rounded rectangle made right there? And really any approximation of this will work, guys. You just cannot believe how forgiving it really is. Because our brains really do fill in the blanks. And then I'm going to come up, I'm going to make a little arc almost like like a little mosque steeple or something. Like that. See that there? Yeah, that's how I do it. I'll make another one because I want to put a color inside that. I want to have a color inside there. I think that will be very colorful. And, you know, you can add... They have a smaller size detail brush. And you can get that too. I'm just having such an easy time with light pressure in the tip that it's just working out for me. Oh, did the Gnomosa fairy come? I think a secret Gnomosa fairy came and brought me Mo Gnomosa. Don't you wish you were in the studio with me right now? Because you know I'm having a good time. I hope you're laughing with me. I hope you feel like I'm in your home with your friends. I hope you feel like I'm there. I always try to make sure that you feel like you're in my studio with me. And then I'm there with you. We're trans-dimensional. That's how awesome we are. All right, so I want to do like a little flower here. I'm going to make a little upward petal. This is sort of like this little lotus flower, and I just liked it, so that's what I did. Alright? You don't even have to get that serious about it. You could have a daisy here. It's just fine. You could do another rose here, especially if you printed it out. You could make it small and trace it right there. And have as many of those as you want. I think this time I'm going to make a little leaf go out, and a little leaf go out. And I'll put that line there, and that'll be green. Yeah, because sometimes I'll just change it up. That will just happen on occasion. Right? And now, there's too much Mosa. What is the third Mosa? Oh! There's another Mosa for you! He brought all the Mosa! If at some point the Sherpa falls down during the teaching of the May the 4th Stormtrooper Dies de los Muertos, we can thank the husband for that. That's just... All right, so you made these, so I got to see how you did. It is just good, even with a pineapple garnish.
We used to better cider this time.
Better cider? There is no... There's just whatever... There's a better cider? I didn't dig far enough into the fridge is what my problem was. Tip. Dig far into your husband's good cider stash. Tip. He took the cider back. He's not really sharing with you. Because I've turned him on to it.
As soon as you get someone to come into the studio, we'll paint.
All right, yeah. Come into the studio. We'll paint with you. Are we going to be like freaking out? We said that later.
Edit.
Everyone at home is going, could you keep painting now? Because I will be alone, so it may not get edited. It may just be is what it is. I'm going to make another little flower here. And a little vine going down. And I'm going to make another little flower here. I just like flowers. And another little vine going down. And then, of course, you know, I gotta have a heart. And I'm gonna have the hearts face downward. So see, every time you do this, you should have something different to say. It shouldn't be just like a carbon copy of whatever happened before. You should be like, oh, I'm gonna do it like a little bit differently this time. I'm gonna flesh this out just a little bit more. And see, I don't worry when I thicken that up because I know I'm gonna paint into it and it's gonna be okay. So I've got that there. And one of the things that I think is really important is the zigzag here. I like that. Did I forget to paint that in white and you guys have been screaming at me the whole video? It, because the headband is blue. That's why. All right, while we're here, just grab some white paint. You could make it black or you could make it white. If you're gonna leave it just plain, it should just be black. So get your brush. You can do the rainbow like what I did on the Etsy one. Go by the Etsy store, get some ideas. You can just do this one black as well. This is really just about what you're about, okay? Don't let it, man, my little rugrats are loud today. Don't let it get to you. Don't let the little stuff get to you. Okay, so I've got that in there. And while that's drying, one of the cool things that we can do is we can put in the base for the daisy. I really like the daisy eyes, so I'm gonna keep those. Right. Hope you're enjoying the kid noise in the background. They really like the coloring sheet, so I hope your little brushes are liking the coloring sheet. Made a little half circle here. And I'm not worried that this is a little bit gray because I'm going to come back with yellow after. That's spoiler. Make sure that my daisy's got the... I just like to mimic the shape. You could leave it white. I'm going to come back with yellow over it. But I've got to put the white in first so the yellow won't even show, is what it is. So just enjoy this. I hope you're goofing. I hope you're having fun. All right. Let's finish off these flowers while we're letting him resolve. So you've got a little bit of purple and a little bit of red. Okay. Then you're going to get some white. And get this great color, and it's going to be quite light. And you're going to come here on the inside and just do a little bit, and a little bit on the outside. Okay? And then you're going to just, without taking all your dark color away, the trick to this is just pulling down some light color into your roses. All right? What your dark color was, you're just pulling in some light color into your roses. Especially on the pulled out petals. See how that's just suddenly, it just really doesn't even take that many colors to do it. Just a couple value changes. Even on a highly decorative piece, it's not that involved, okay? So just have fun with it. Look at that there. It just happens. You're like, it's like a magic trick. An awesome, awesome magic trick. Yeah, it's exactly like that because it's just what your eye is finishing it. Let's all be magicians and just let the eye finish the roses. And again, the trick is don't paint on all this dark paint. Let it be a dry brush. A little bit in the center, a little bit right there. See how I come here and I just highlight, a little bit down. This is the best coloring book you've ever done. Yeah. Totally fine, right? You made it yourself. Isn't that crazy? DIY your own coloring page. And it practically is. Definitely, definitely share your pictures with me and your art stories and your journey and your parties that you have. I love when you guys have home parties with these, with your family, with your friends, in group. Groups. I love it when it's in care facilities. That's amazing to me. Look at all that takes to just suddenly give that some dimension. Now, I want you to understand, we're going to see these really up close, okay? These are not like crazy better than yours at home, all right? These are just like what you're doing at home. I'm only just more confident and comfortable with what's happening. All right, so you guys are doing fine. I'm just tipping the outside. Right now you're just so excited. I hope you're doing roses. I hope like all of a sudden you're gonna be like, wait, I can just do that? Yeah, and this will be the basis for a conversation we're gonna have a little later about actually painting very hyper-realistic roses. Someone had done a fantastic little class on Facebook and shared. They had these terrific dewdrops. I'm not dishing names because I didn't get permission first. I try not to like put you guys out there without like asking first. Even if I think it will be cool, I do my best to be respectful of that because I know that can be a real thing. Art is very personal. Look at that. You have roses now. Well, I bet you can guess what's coming next. We are going to get some blue, pull it out, and get some yellow, and pull it out, make a very bright green, add some white to that green, and you're gonna come on your leaf, and from the inside of the leaf, that halfway point, you're gonna just take out a little extra color, okay? That's all you're gonna do. You're just pulling out some extra color. And then all we gotta do is color this in and we will have made this. Now I will absolutely, cause I know for some of you are just already halfway through coloring this and you didn't need me to show you through that at all cause that's just where you are. But that's not where everybody is in their art journey. So sometimes I'm going to be like, all right, for the everybody who's here and all the different places we are in the art journey, now, you notice I'm kind of jumping around. I'm trying to make some more of this. I'm going to do, it's an interesting brush stroke. I've got this little bright, and I'm going to go like this. I'm going to go flick, 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 flick. Flick, 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 flick. I'm going to add these weird little leaves to the world because I like to. All it is a flicking stroke. I am not trying to tell you everything you need to know about leaves. I'm just allowing the paint and the brush to do it. It's just fun. It's just fun, right? Tricks. When I'm making the stroke, sometimes I change directions a little bit, right? Once that's in, I'm going to come back and grab my black for just this one last time, except where I need to improve a line or something. And I'm going to very carefully, without painting it out, create a black line that sort of follows my green line. And I do this because I want some visual weight. Now, you may be really happy with your black, your green line, and you want to just leave it alone. This is just something I like. It's just how I am, so I'm not gonna do it on the green flicks. It's just on this curlicue, just to create more of a visually dense pattern here. But again, you could do it just with a green. I just like it to be unified. I have black lining throughout the piece. So for me, I like black lining throughout. But you might be like, you know, I like that one spot did not have black lining. Or you might be like, dude, I don't feel like I could get that thing lined away that would make... Now, I want you to notice something. I'm not perfectly tracing over. It's fine. Right? And when you guys see my paintings, a lot of times you'll be like, oh, that's pretty. I'm good with that. But like on your own paintings, you're like, oh my God, it's not working out. Well, you know what time it is then? Mimosa. I'm going to take this. That's really nice. I wish I'd known about this sooner. Yum! Color it in. Alright. I'm going to grab their smallest filbert. For the Maestro series, which is a number 2, we'll say filbert. And I'm going to get some blue and white. just some blue and white. In between my clouds and my little spires, I'm gonna paint blue and white. Okay, that's what I'm gonna do there. I like that. You might be doing a traceable. You might have found another sugar skull that you like better. All of that is acceptable. There is no wrong answer to this question. And one thing I want to say is make sure it's dry. So hit it with a hair dryer if you need it to be dry, or wait till it's dry, but don't try to do this when it's wet, because you really want to be able to rest your hand to steady it if you need to, if you're tired. If you're tired, and you might be tired. Okay, so I've got that in. You could, if you took the galaxy lesson, right there, if you did galaxy, you could paint space right up here. You could do this whole light with space. See, you just layer those up. You could use owl, you put an owl right here. There's just no limit to what you can do. I'm gonna get a little bit of yellow, and I'm gonna get a little bit of red, and a little bit of yellow. And I'm really got it just sort of glopped on my brush there, because I want some streaking. And I didn't even get enough red, apparently, so I'm gonna get a little more red. There we go. I want the center of this to be a little more orange-red. Right? It's a little bit red, it's a little bit yellow, it's sort of both. It's multi-tonal. Right, you see that there? Get a little bit of white on that brush. I haven't even rinsed it out. Notice that I didn't even rinse it out. Got those little sun spikes going out. Still haven't rinsed it out. And you're like, wait, this feels like the sunflowers. That's right. See those scales? They layer. The skills layer. Oh, my daughter's singing. She's a singer. She sings a lot. Mostly she likes to sing that she's the greatest singer in the world over and over again. If she's not singing, Let It Go. And I'm really wishing she would let it go. That song has really, really been sung a lot in my house. I don't know about your house, but I've heard Let It Go a lot. So see how a bunch of crazy tones. So that's what I can do that people, you know, can't do when they have markers, you know. So I'm gonna come here, and this side will be yellow. Maybe I'll do this side yellow too. I'll see how it goes. I'm just gonna do some colors down. I'm gonna grab some just red. Paint some colors down here. Not really a rainbow, but we're going to use a bunch of colors. I don't want the red and yellow near my sun, so that's why I'm putting them up here. You color as neatly as you need to. I just want to guide you through this, so I'm not too worried about it. Maybe I will get some purple and some white here. I'll put some purple here. That's a nice break. Kind of crazy and weird. You could follow an exact rainbow pattern like we did in the unicorn mane. Wow, I'm not actually even selling my own lessons. I'm just saying that there is the flame touches from one skill to the next. You know, it's like when I was talking about, you know, and even if I haven't really enjoyed every art teacher, I've gotten something from them. One thing that was worth my time being there every time. So I got that there. And I think I'll do like a green. I I'll do like a green right here. I got that green. Then I will just do a straight blue. And so that is the top of the head that we're doing. We're just whipping right through this. You didn't even know it was going to be that fast, that easy, did ya? Things that I'm not stressing about. You can always come back and strengthen a line. You can always do this as slowly as you like, as quickly as you like, as loose as you like, as tight as you like. It is just up to you. I'm going to rinse out my brush. Rinse. And then get some just yellow. And yes, I'm getting from the center of the paper up as I just need to pull it down here and my brush is clean. But don't do that in general. And I'm just going to make sure that my daisy here is painted in yellow. And it may be time to get more clean water. And that just happens. Get clean water when you need to get clean water. I will just use the magic of edit. Woohoo! Still loving these Maestro brushes. I'm still happy with them. I'm still good. Still feel good talking about them. Got a little white there. I'm coming over here. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with how this is coming out. And again, like, just painted two paintings now with them and they're still working out. That's a good sign. And then you can see me painting with a brush that, you know, you can easily get because these are on Amazon. That was another thing I really liked about it. I was like, oh, they're on Amazon. That's easy to get. And I like that it's easy to get. Take a little yellow and white and mix them together. I'm going to paint my star. I struggled to get in, but look, it's coming out. See, sometimes everybody struggles to get something in. I think I'm going to go through and I'm going to just get all my yellow petals in while I've got it out. So I know I want these yellow. If your brush gets clumpy, wipe it out. Wipe it on a towel. Wipe it wherever you need to. Just do what you gotta do. I know I'd like a little yellow right there. Like a little yellow right there. Maybe these upper little zigs could be yellow. And then the reverse could be yellow right here. It's the upper zigs over here, but you could change it up. There's no wrong. I'm gonna paint my hidden zig. Right? And then I also think I would like some yellow in this flower right here. And in these two little detaches. So see how that just went in there and I was like, where can I put my yellow? It doesn't mean I won't be getting in my yellow again. I will be getting in my yellow again. But right now, I'm going to take a little green over to my yellow plot. Because I want to make some different greens. Wipe it off if you need to. Get water where you need to. Oh, I've got a nice flow there. Some white into it. Sometimes white will help with the coverage, especially on student paints. That's an area that student paints will just give you grief, is student paints often will not paint over what's underneath them. And you find that you have been, I'm going to come up here and paint these little leaves in here too. Dab, dab, dab. Dab, 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 dab. I am not being crazy about all these little spaces. It is about an overall feeling. Okay? You're totally welcome to be crazy about all these little spaces if you'd like. But you don't have to be to get a good result. Put symbolism in that matters to you, too. That's another acceptable thing to do. Now, I think here I'm going to do little flowers that are not black line. These little leaves coming off here because I just think I'd like it. I feel like that would be cool. Little dabs implying leaves that are not outlined. How awesome is that? Just something I'd like. I'm going to rinse out my brush. Rinse out my brush. And I think I'll grab some red. So for sure I know I want my hearts in here to be red. I know I want those red. Need to have some red corazón. Some red hearts. And again, if you mess up your lines, go back, paint them out. Like I messed up a line there, I'm going to go back when it's dry and put it back. What I'm not going to do is just freak out on myself. I'm going to bring a little purple over my red. I'm kind of mimic some of what I did on my roses over here. A little bit, some tones, right? Red and purple, just mimicking some tones. Painting this in. And then over here I'm gonna get some just white. A little more white. And each petal coming out, I'm going to have be a little bit lighter. You have to wipe off your brush. Go ahead and do it. A little more white paint. So they're just not the same. Oh, and see, I forgot a place that I was going to put green. And so sometimes as you're doing this, you'll be like, wait, I want a green here and here. And you didn't know you did. Add a little there. Then I will grab some of that leftover green and I think I'm going to put that right into these leaves right here because that's where I want that. Put that in those leaves. And I think I might want some green in the center of these daisies. Center of these daisies. Blue, my next color. Oh, and I think maybe red here. Actually, my next color will be red. I want some more red. Not enough red. I'm going to paint these in red. And maybe these outer spikes in red. So you just look. I'm always saying the lessons, and you'll see I'm doing it here. I'm looking for holes. I'm looking for places that I'd like more of a color than what I have, or color I feel like there is not represented well enough within the piece. And that's just all I want you to do, is just enjoy what you're doing. Experiment. I'll put a little dab of red here, 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 and here on the inside of that flower because I just want to. Right? And now I feel like red should be around the star. I don't, but you might not feel red should be around the star. You might be like, I don't want the star to be red. You know what? Dude, you got to make it your own. I'm just talking to you about stuff that we can do together as a group. And then maybe what you want to do is this looking really cool? Is something that you can do to, you know, that's more your own. And I love seeing that too. You guys are always so cute. Like, I'm sorry, I changed it. Like, change it. Change it. You don't need to paint like me. I already paint like me. You paint like you. I got your back. I share the skills. You're going to find your way. You're going to figure out who you are as a creative person. You're going to love it. You do not need to paint like me. Not necessary. not a requirement at all. Right? Not a requirement at all. Okay, so I like that. I'm gonna add the last little bit because I think I'm gonna do purple and blue everywhere else. No, that's not where I want it. That's up here. I can paint that out later. So I'm not even worried about that. Purple and blue everywhere else. Fur some purple. All right, I think I want these to be purple and these to be purple. That's just how I feel about it today. A little purple right there. I had just purple and white and I just colored those right in. Oh, maybe I want these up here to be purple. The little spires with the yellow because they're contrast. That's always nice. So that little pattern. You could paint this any set of decorative colors to go with any room, any decor, any dorm room. Doesn't matter. Any boy's room. You make this boyish. You can make this girlish. You make this festive or somber or just whatever you want. Today is how I'm coloring. I might color differently tomorrow. I don't know. Okay. So I'm going to color in these spikes up here with blue. That's what I'm going to do. And there's other detail brushes in the set you could use. I'm just comfortable with the filberts. But you could do a detail. If a brush is giving you grief, switch brushes, which is why sometimes it's nice to have a wide selection of brushes to choose from. However you get them, like if you get the kit like this or you create your own kit, having a wide selection allows you to make changes when you need to. A lot of kids in today's soundtrack. A lot of kids today's soundtrack. Apparently it's funny out there and I'm missing it. I'm gonna go play with those kids. As soon as we're done. Put some little blue here. I feel like this should be blue. And then I'm also feeling, oh my goodness, are we wrapping up? There's no way. We are. I cannot believe we accomplished this in this amount of time. Really thought, I was worried it was going to be like a solid 3 hours. Like you're going to be like, oh my God. Oh my God, it's like a solid 3 hours. But it's not. And it's not. Oh no, wait. I feel a disturbance in the force. There's two things we have yet to do, and then we're done. So grab your detail brush, and I'm gonna put out a little fresh white paint. So, cause I got a little messy with, see this paint management, and then I lose paint and it wastes and it's no good. So next to my pineapple, I'm gonna put out a little fresh white paint just for this next little bit. Because we have this sort of black, and we don't just want that. We want something going on in there. So I'm gonna load up my detail brush and in the headband, I'm gonna make a dot right here at the center and then I'm going to do those swirls that I practiced so well. Coming out. Okay? And then I'm going to do them going the opposite direction. Just coming out, creating some sort of decorative textural element right up here. So that's defined. And just above the eye line, I'm gonna do a little white line here. Just so that that's more defined, okay? Because we really don't want our little trooper people to be like flipping out going, that's not really technically a helmet, and you know, they can. All right, the other thing I think is really important left and totally worth your time to add is the grill. So put a line right in the center and just come out adding lines at equally spaced intervals. Intervals. Always look in your pieces for little areas that you might have missed or you feel need more thought or consideration. Okay? If you take your little lines down too far, don't worry, you can paint them out. So I feel like on that side I did. I want the lines to end sort of right here. So I'm gonna go back and paint out with the black paint my white lines because I don't really want them that far down. Okay. That is it. That is our May the 4th be with you intergalactic holiday special. I hope that your week is full of awesome geekery. I hope you're loving all the shows. I hope we all like the movie when it comes out so much. May your family be happy, healthy, and well. May you and your friends be great. May your furry friends be great. And may the force be with you. I want to see you at this easel really soon. Okay, bye-bye. We're just saying it. We're just saying, Happy May the 4th, everybody! Beware of Revenge of the 5th!
We have 10 minutes left.
Okay. Of total film?
Total film.
Okay. Alright, what if you were right here? Okay.
Behind you! Oh!
It's not working, is it?
No. I'm too big.